Hi, I'm Mr. Chinyo. You're welcome to my study room. If today is your first time coming here, I strongly encourage you to subscribe to my channel for more videos. Today we have laws of logarithm. And here we are going to learn about three main laws and then two properties of logarithm, which we are going to use to calculate or solve questions involving logarithm. So let's go straight to the first law, which I will call the law of products. Yeah, this law says that if you have log m n base a, then this is the same as log m plus log n, each of them to the base a. This means that if you have the logarithm of the product of two numbers, this is the same as logarithm of the first one to the base plus logarithm of the second one to the same base. Let's take example. So log 6 base 5, and this 6 here is 2 times 3. Base 5. And this is going to be, or this is the same as log 2 base 5 plus log 3 base 5. You can just verify this with your calculator. You check log 6 base 5, you write the answer down, and then you check log 2 plus log 3 base 5 and see whether they will give you the same answer. The answer for this will be the same as the answer for this. That's just what you are trying to do. Let's take another one, maybe log 20. So 20, let's say there's 2. 20 has so many factors. So the combination of any of the factors will be 20 can be 2 times 10, so it can be 5 times 4. All of them will give you 20. So any of them will do, this is 2 times 10. Base 2. So this will be the same as log 2 base 2 plus log 10 base 2. Because the same 20 is also 4 times 5. The answer will be log 4, the first one base 2, plus, because of the multiplication, log 5. Base 2. Then those are all just proving this law, that the logarithm of product is the same as the summation of the logarithm of each of the factors to the same base. Let's take the second law, which I'll call the law of quotient. Like I said, the second law is the quotient law, the law of quotient. And quotient, as you know, that is division. So if you take logarithm of the quotient of two numbers to a base, the answer you will get will be the same as logarithm of the numerator to that base minus logarithm of the denominator to the same base. So we took an example. Because numbers, operation on numbers give us other numbers, I think it is difficult for us to write what gave us that number. So I took log 5 base 2. Different divisions can give us 5. For example, 25 divided by 5 can give us 5. 50 divided by 10 can give us 5. And so on and so forth. So I decided to choose 15 divided by 3. It also gives us 5. So you can choose any two numbers that when you divide, they will give you 5 as your number inside. So I choose 15 divided by 3 just because I will get 5 from there to stand for the quotient. So that is log 15 base 2 minus log 3 base 2, which gave us the answer we would have got if we just do log 5 base 2. And like I said, you can try it for any other division that can give you 5. 50 divided by 10 is 5. So you can do log 50 to a base minus log 5 to the same base, and you see that you still get log 10, sorry, minus log 10 to the same base, and you still get 5. The only thing is that the division should give you 5 at the end of the day. So that is law 2. Let's go to law 3.
the law of exponents. This is law 3, the law of exponents. This one says that when you take the logarithm of a number with an exponent, the answer you get will be the same as the exponent times the logarithm of that number to the same base. So I have two examples here. We take logarithm of 5 cubed base 2. The answer you will get is the same as when you bring the 3 down here to kind of multiply the log. So it becomes 3 log 5 base 2. Another example here is that log 21 squared base 3 is 2 log 21 base 3. There are some few, or there are two properties I would like us to add to this law in our calculations. Let's take those properties as well. Alright, these are two properties. And the first property is log a base a equals 1. What this means is that when you take the logarithm of a number to the same base, the answer you get is 1. And in fact, that makes sense according to our definition of logarithm. Because this number here, exponent 1, will just give us the same thing. So it makes a lot of sense. So we have some examples here that log 7 base 7 is 1, log 10 base 10 is 1. You can do log 81 base 81, anything at all. You can use your calculator to verify this rule. So it means that in our subsequent calculations, whenever we calculate to the extent where we get a number, we will get a logarithm of a number to the base which is the same as the number, we are going to use 1 to represent that. Then we come to the second one, log 1 base a is 0. Meaning that the logarithm of 1 to any base at all is always 0. Again, when we take the definition of logarithm, it makes sense. Because any number exponent 0 is 1. So, example, we can take log 1 base 5, it will be 0. So we have log 1, we have log 1 base 100 equal to 0. It doesn't matter the base. If you are just taking logarithm of 1, then your answer will always be 0. You can verify these two with your calculator. So I would like us to take some 4 questions applying these laws and properties you have just learned. Then we'll see whether we will see how it works in logarithm. But before that, let me just state quickly that anytime the logarithm is written without a base, it means that that logarithm is in base 10. So your calculators have been programmed to work in base 10. So you see that the logarithm on your calculator has no base attached to it. The main one has no base before there's another function that has a box where you put the base. So whenever it's in base 10, you can decide to write a base or not write a base. But the main point here is that anytime the logarithm is written without a base, it means it is in base 10. And for you watching right now, what it means to you too is that even if you are working in a different base and you forget to write a base, the examiner takes it at base 10. Because whenever the base of a logarithm is not written, it means it's in base 10. I just want to quickly add that one. So in the solution we are giving now, and I don't write a base, it means that we are working in base 10. Let us now take this example. These are the examples. The general instruction is express each of the following as a single logarithm. Alright, so we are just going to apply these 3 laws we have learned, and if possible, the properties to express this one so that it will have only log something. That is all you want to do. Alright, so when you look at this, you see that the first law that we can apply here is the third law, the law of exponents. So it means that this one is going to carry the exponent, this one is going to carry the exponent, and that is all we are doing. So this becomes log 25 exponent 1 over 2. Please tell me square root of 25 anyway. Minus log 3 cubed, then plus log 18. Alright. Then after doing this, we know that this will mean log And now we are going to do something. I'm going to explain this later. But then we have to bring the additions together and bring the subtraction to the last terms. And I will explain why we have to send the subtraction last.
So, like I said, 25 exponent, 1/2 is the same as square root of 25. So that will give us 5. Then this will be plus log 18, because I said we should bring the positive terms next, and then we send the minus log 3 cubed is 27. Alright. So now that we have expressed all of them to be log something having the same base, remember we said when the base is not written, it means it's in base 10. Then all those that are adding, that means multiplication, the law of product, and the subtraction is division, the law of quotient. So we are going to factor the log out, so to speak, have the log out. Then we are going to have 5 times 18 because of the addition, then divided by 27 because of the subtraction. Then now we work out what is in the bracket so that we have a single logarithm being the answer. So this is going to give us 9 will go here 3 times and then go here 2. So we are going to have log 5 times 2 is 10 over 3 as our single logarithm. So this is the single logarithm we are looking for. Let us take question 2. So question 2, the same instruction, we are expressing it as a single log. But here there is a new problem added to it. We don't have, the 3 here doesn't have a logarithm attached to it. So when we are grouping, how do we group? Don't panic. Anytime we have a whole number, remember that property that says that log to the same base is 1. So the only thing is that you introduce your same, your log to have the base as the common base among all of them to that same number, then it doesn't change anything because the number wouldn't multiply that one as 1. So for example, this one, we just introduce our own log to be 3 log, remember the common base is 4, so 4 base 4, and we know that the 4 base 4, log 4 base 4 is 1 according to what we have done so far. So 1 times 3, it doesn't change anything about the 3. But now we have logarithm which is common for us to work with. So that is going to give us plus 3rd log to this one, and that will give us log 4 cubed base 4 plus log 6 base 4 minus log 2 exponent 5 is 32 base 4 minus log 8 over 3 base 4. Alright. So 4 cubed is 64. That is 4 times 4 is 16. 16 times 4 is 64. So this is going to be log 64 base 4 plus log 6 base 4 minus log 32 base 4 minus log 8 over 3 base 4. So here, because of this division, there are two things we can do here. We can expand this one alone using the second law, the law of quotient, which will be right, but then we don't want this negative to confuse a lot of people. So we are going to work this one, these 3 here first, then when we finish,
we bring this one last. We achieve the same result. But those who want to expand, they can also do that. But you should just remember that this negative is affecting everything you get. So you have to keep this one, put it in a bigger bracket, and work it out, and use the negative one to expand that bracket. But to avoid that, we are going to do something different, which I think is a little simpler than that option.
This will give us log 64 times 6 all over 32. Then base 4 minus, we still keep our log there because it's division, we don't want to cause any confusion. So we have 4 here. Good. Now 32 will go here 1, goes here 2. So to work it further, this one now gives us log 2 times 6 is 12. So log 12 base 4 minus log all. We can just work it straightforward now. So they all have the same base. We are grouping. So we have log 12 divided by 8 over 3. Remember, we are stressing at a single log. And this becomes log 12 times 3 over 8. This form. So 4 is a common factor here. 4 goes here 2 and then goes here 3. So this gives us log 9 over 2. This 4. This gives us log 9 over 2. This 4 as our single log that we are expressing our third thing. So we take our third example. Example 3 here. The same thing. We are expressing it as a single log. So let's go straight to it. Log 3. So this gives us log 27 exponent 1 over 3 minus log 144 exponent 1 over 2, because this is moving there, then minus log 3 squared plus log 18. Remember, this is a whole number, so we are introducing our own log to the same base so that the value doesn't change. So this will be log 10. Remember, there is no base, so it means that it's in base 10. So log 10 base 10 will be 1. So we didn't change that, but now we have made all of them to be in log so that we can group them to be the same log. Let's go forward now. So this one, 27 exponent 1 over 3 is the same as cube root of 27 according to indices. So that will give us 3. This will give us log 3 minus 144 exponent 1 half is the same as square root of 144, which is 12. So this is 12. Then minus log 9 plus log 18. Then plus log 10. Good. Again, to avoid that confusion, I am sending all the negative to the last, and then I bring positive 10 closer. So this is going to give us log 3 plus log 18 plus log 10 minus log 12 minus log 9. Alright, so we are grouping them as a single log, combining logs 1 and 2 together. Log 1 will apply for the addition, and then log 2 will apply for the subtraction. So let's go. That gives us log, parenthesis here, we have 3 because of this times 18 because of this times 10. Then divided by, you go to the subtraction now, 12
times 9. And that's how we combine them.
So here we are going to have log, then we do the division. 9 goes here, 1 goes into 18 twice. 3 goes here, 1 goes here, 4. Then 2 goes here, 1 goes here, 1. No, 2 goes here, 2. 2 goes here, 2 goes here, 1. The same 2 goes here, 1 goes here, 5. Or you can do all the multiplication for the numerator. You do all the multiplication for the denominator, then you divide. So this is going to give us log 5 as our single logarithm. Remember here we didn't write a base, because if we don't write a base, it means that it's in base 10. Let us take the fourth example now. Question 4. We are expressing the whole of this as a single logarithm. So let's go. We are just going to apply the laws as we have done so far, the properties all together. So this is going to give us log 30 over 16 plus, because I want to put the negative 10 plus, so plus log, this is 400, sorry, so plus log 400 over 243 then minus, I bring this my term now, and I will just expand everything at once. So log 5 squared is 25 over 9 squared is 81. Good. And here, expressing them as a single log, you are going to have log 30 over 16 times, because of the plus, 400 over 243, then divided by, because of the subtraction, 25 over 81. Good. Then expressing further, this will give us log 30 over 16 times 400 over 243, then times 81 over 25. Remember, we have changed sign. So we reciprocate this one. Good. Let's see whether we can do a few cancellations. So 81 goes to itself 1, goes here 3 times. Then 25 goes here 1, goes here 16 times. And then 16 will go into itself 1, goes into 16 1. Then 3 goes here 1, goes into 30 10 times. And like I always say, you can, instead of doing these calculations one by one, you can multiply all the numerators and put it together. You multiply all the denominators and put them together and reduce. So this is going to give us log 10. And we know already, since we didn't write a base, it means in base 10. And log to the same base is 1. So our final answer is 1. And this is our final answer. Let us take the last question, then we take some examples. So, okay, 5. We are expressing the whole of this as a single logarithm. Let's see how we work it. So we change each of these terms into indices so that we see how we are going to do it. Or we can even work it like this. So let's just work them ourselves. So this is going to be log square root of 35 times root 2 divided by root 7. And if we remember our said lessons well, we will know that the numerator will be the same as square root of 35 times, because this is 35 times 2 over square root of 7. And that will be the same as log root 70 over 7. Square root of root 70 over 7. Another thing is said that when you have a set over another set, you can express both of them with one set. So this will give us log, this one goes here and goes here 10 times. So log of root 10, which will be the same as the logarithm of 10 exponent 1 over 2. And if we should apply the third law, this will be the same as 1 over 2 log 10, which is the same as 1. So our final answer becomes 1/2. And this is where we end today's study on the laws of logarithm. Expect more videos on problems involving logarithm. But before I go, as usual, I will leave out some questions just after this session for you to try. Don't hesitate to leave your answers in the comment box. But more importantly, I encourage you once again to subscribe to my channel if today is your first time visiting here. And share with friends that there is easy way of solving the various mathematical topics, and Mr. Chu is sharing it with all of us. Thank you for watching, and see you again. Bye-bye.